This video is going to be on how to change the chain case oil in a 2016 Yamaha Viper. First thing you need to do is take the cover off. Okay, if you've never done this, it's pretty easy to get the side cover off. Just pop that pin out and lift up here. And open it up, comes right off. Set it aside. And take this one off. Just pull back on that. And I've never actually done this, so this is gonna be interesting. I'm gonna have to take the exhaust out. And might have to take this bottom cover off too. Not 100% sure, but I'll figure it out and let you guys know. You also need to disconnect the oxygen sensor, and that's plugged in right up there. So just disconnect that. Okay, so it looks like there's a spring down there that needs to come out or unhook from the exhaust, so the exhaust will lift straight up and out, and you can just hold this out of the way, the flange. Another thing I want to mention when working on a snowmobile, a handy tool to have is a little magnetic reach tool. In case you drop something down in there, you can just grab it out. Not that I dropped a bolt down there. I'm just gonna grab onto that spring with these vice grips. Okay, so I just left the vice grips hooked onto that spring and the exhaust came out pretty easily. So this is looking like it's going to be pretty involved. I've never done this before, like I said, so looks like I'm going to have to change the engine oil while I'm at this. So I'm going to have to drain the oil tank here because the oil tank needs to come right out of here by the looks of it, so I can get at the chain case cover that's in behind it. So it looks like there's going to be quite a bit of work to do. The next step, I'm going to have to take the seat off to get the shroud out of the way and expose things a little bit better just to make things easier. And looks like this little foot cover has to come off. And I'll get going on that now. Corkscrew that holds that seat bracket on. So you back that out and then just pull this tab out to lift the seat straight up and out of the way. So I removed the left-hand side cover to get that cover off that goes under the tank. So there it is, and there's that other piece. So that's just gonna free up some space, so it makes this whole job a whole lot easier. Now I've already ordered a full synthetic oil change kit, so I'm just waiting on that to come in. But I figured I would start draining the oil and get everything drained out and reassembled, so I can just dump the new oil in once it shows up, and the filter too. So the next thing I'm going to do is take this foot cover off, and I'll let you know what size Torx screws that are as soon as I figure that out. Okay, so that was a Torx T20 to remove this foot guard, and there's two at the bottom and two up here at the top. So I've already removed that, and what I like to do is just whenever I take a part off, is just put the bolts back in it so I know exactly where they go. So we'll set that aside. And that exposes the drain plug down there. But it looks like I'm going to have to make up some type of a diverter to drain the oil out through this hole because it's kind of offset. Otherwise, it's just going to make a big, big mess, and we don't want that. So I'm going to see what I can whip up to facilitate this. Okay, here's what I came up with, what I'm gonna use to drain the oil out. Gonna need a 14 millimeter wrench. I got a little ratchet box end, and then I just cut the top of an oil can off, and I got a rag, and I'll show you how all that looks once it's in place and draining. But the drain plug's right down there, so I'm gonna loosen that off and get things set up and then show you. Okay, so the oil's draining away there, and it's just draining through the top of that oil can down through the bottom of the snowmobile, and I just stuffed a rag in there to kind of hold the top of that oil can in place, and so far no spillage, just straight into the oil drain. Just noticed looks like I'm gonna need an exhaust gasket too, so I'll have to order one of those and get that in. So just make sure you have one on hand, because you're likely gonna need it. Looks like it tore there, but not a big deal. Can't see that being too much money. So it looks like the oil is all done draining now, so I'm gonna go ahead and put the drain plug back in and remove my little funnel contraption. So I just unplugged the plug for the reverse actuator, and I'm going to remove it from the tank with looks like a T20 Torx bit. Okay, so that's out of the way, and it looks like I'm gonna have to disconnect this connector here too. So I've disconnected all those connectors, so everything will be up out of the way and free and clear when I take the tank off. So to do that, I'm gonna take this off, but looks like I'm gonna have to take that off and disconnect this line and the two at the bottom. Okay, I've got one line out. That one connected up here and down there at the bottom. It was just held on by these clamps here. You just squeeze them together like pliers, and I removed the top, I think it's a vent, and that's up out of the way. I also had to remove this little holder device down here, just one little screw, so you can get this line down off the tank, and then that bottom line down there too. Okay, so I removed this little screw here that holds this on, so you can pull it back out of the way, and I just tuck this connector up in behind the tank, so everything's a lot more free and clear to hoist it out of here. Now I think, rather than separating it at the oil tank to the chain case cover, I'm just going to remove the entire oil tank and chain case cover together. And to do that, it looks like there's, I don't know how many of those black Torx bit screws that I'll have to remove, but I'm gonna get all those out and see how it comes out. Like I said, I've never done this, so it's I'm just kind of doing it freestyle on my own. I'm not even using a manual on this yet. So all those bolts are out now, and it's just draining. You just want to make sure you got your drain pan placed underneath here to catch all the oil. And yeah, needed quite a few tools to get all those bolts out. Extensions and adapters, or, you know, a little ratchet, quarter inch ratchet with an extension. I basically used all those tools to get those bolts out, because some of them are pretty tricky to get at. Okay, so I got that cover out all in one piece. It's a little tricky. A few of these little parts kind of fell out, so I'm gonna probably have to locate a manual to make sure I get that all put back together. for the reverse, but not too big of a deal. But you can see down here, and I heard about this, how it's got that wear mark down there in the case. What that's from is from all these magnets on this gear down here that build up with little metal filings, and I guess it actually wears into the case. So that's why it's important to take this all apart this way and clean that up. So I'll just wipe all that metallic fuzz off those magnets with a rag and get everything all cleaned up and reassembled. And once I figure out how all that reverse actuator goes back together, but it shouldn't be that big of a deal. One other thing before it all goes back together is clean it all out with a rag and just check your these little chain sliders here. Make sure they're not too worn. If they are, replace those. Okay, here's the correct orientation of your chain case gears and actuator for reverse. You want to make sure the short side of this is facing in. You want to make sure your gear is in, like, with the flat side out, and your spring, your collar, and make sure this magnet's cleaned up and your two posts all the way in. And if you lose this washer when you take it apart, that's where it goes. And one other thing to note, before I took the chain case cover off, I should have taken out the reverse actuator shaft and the little notch thing there. But I'll show you how that all goes back together. And yeah, that's it. Okay, so we're down here underneath. I thought I'd drain the rest of the oil out. You can see I've already taken out the oil filter and a little drain plug where the drips are coming down right there. So you just got to remove this panel underneath and you can have access to those two things. So there's the drain bolt. It's got a little copper washer on it, and there's the oil filter. I had to wrap a rag around the oil filter because I didn't have the right oil filter wrench to fit it, but that's just what I did to make it work. So I'm just draining that out, and then still waiting on my oil change kit. So as soon as that comes in, I can put the new filter in and I'll put the drain bolt back in. But until then, I'll just keep the drain pan underneath and let it drain. There's a cover there that goes underneath. It's got four T30 Torx bolts. Okay, finally got the oil change kit in. I opted for the full synthetic 0W40 with a new oil filter and gaskets for both the drain bolts. So I'm gonna pick up where we left off. So I've got all the black Torx bolts all tightened up on the chain case cover all the way around, and I got all the hoses hooked back onto the oil tank right back the way they were, and up there too. So I'm ready to add the chain case oil. Now Yamaha calls for 12 ounces, so I had to buy two bottles, and then I just brought the level up in the one bottle to 12 ounces. I made up this little funnel with a hose, and I'm just gonna pour it in there and keep an eye on the level window down there. But I'm just gonna dump the 12 ounces in and it should be good to go. And And it looks like the 12 ounces brought it up to the level right where it's supposed to be. I got some information on how to set the reverse actuator gear. And basically, for setting up that, the instructions said that you need to push it in and turn it all the way counterclockwise. And when it's in the position of all the way counterclockwise, so that the reverse actuator is fully out into drive mode. When it's fully turned this way, this little indent should be facing down. And then you can put this piece back in and put it all back together. So after you get it located on the center just like that, you just want to turn this clockwise just a little bit. That's what the Yamaha manual says. So it should look like that before you put the electronic actuator on. Just how that little notch, just move it over a little bit like that. And it's supposed to make the electronic device go on easier. So that went back on pretty straightforward. There was a couple things I forgot to mention. That gear, before you reinstall it, make sure the shaft and those O-rings are coated with lithium grease. And also forgot to mention, when you put these case bolts back in, that there's a little wire holder on the top there. And then down here at the bottom, forgot to mention to reinstall the holder for these oil pipes down below there too. So everything's all hooked back up and it should work fine. I routed the wires all in there just the way they were at the factory, and I put a couple new zip ties on, and I'm ready to reinstall the footwell guard down there. And then I should be able to reinstall the exhaust. I've already made sure the drain plug's tight. And one other thing, I bought a new exhaust gasket because the other one was pretty dickered. So if you need to get a new one, there's the part number. And this one was actually $28, so they're pretty pricey, but like I said, it's very important to make sure your exhaust is sealed, and I had a chunk of the gasket missing, so that's why I bought a new one. I thought about using some high temp silicone, but it's too hot, and I just, for the $28, peace of mind, do the job right. So that's how everything should look when the footwell guard is reinstalled. You got your screw back in the plastic there. Plastic fits in between the frame and the guard and behind. And then you just want these leads left out there. So now I'm finally ready to put the exhaust back in. And what I did before that is I just locked my needle nose channel locks onto the spring and just propped it up there out of the way. So once I put the muffler in, I can just lock it into place by pulling up on that spring and hooking the spring onto the tab on the muffler. Okay, so that's all hooked back into place. What I actually ended up doing was using my needle nose channel locks on the spring, and then I added another pair of channel locks onto that channel lock, or vice grip, sorry, to make it a lot easier to hook that spring back on. So the next thing to do would be to install the new gasket in between the flanges, take off my vice grips, and plug the oxygen sensor back into the plug up top there. Okay, the new exhaust gasket's in there. The bolts are back in, all tightened up. the oxygen sensors plugged back in. Now I just need to put the drain plug back in and the new oil filter. Okay, the filter and drain plug is back in. I'm gonna leave the cover off for now, just so I can start it up and verify that there's no leaks. And according to the manual, it says to put 2.8 liters of oil back into the tank. So I'm gonna go ahead and do that with the Yamalube full synthetic oil. Okay, so it ended up using about 4.6 liters of oil, and that was after running it and checking it and adding more to it, and I'm pretty sure it's right at the perfect level right now, and it was a total of 4.6 liters with complete oil change. And one other thing, I know I've said that a lot in this video, one other thing, there's a lot of things to do in this job, but I noticed online that a lot of guys had cracked their actuator mounts, so just make sure you don't over torque those and put a little blue Loctite on the threads before you put them in. And yeah, I've had it running, cycled it in and out of reverse a bunch of times. I had it supported by my chain fall, so I've ran the track around forwards and backwards. It goes in and out of reverse no problem. Obviously I can't take it out for a ride, it's summertime now, so yeah, overall the job was quite a big job. Not sure if you're going to want to tackle that yourself. If you do, always refer to your manual. Don't rely on my tips for the whole entire thing. But I tried to be as detailed as possible as to how I do it. And yeah, thanks for watching my video. If you like the video, hit the like button, subscribe, leave me a comment. Any other tips you guys have, and hopefully this helps anybody with a Yamaha Viper or the Arctic Cat equivalent. Thanks for watching.